नमस्ते स्टूडेंट, खुश रहो बेटिया। आई कौशिक चक्रवर्ती फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर राजस्थान, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट बायोमेडिकल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग। इन दैट सब्जेक्ट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक इज ERP। दिस इज कॉल्ड द इवेंट रिलेटेड पोटेंशियल्स। इट्स ए इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इन that biomedical signals. Basically, we are discussing in these sessions the various types of signals. And previously, in the last lecture, we are discussed about the electroencephalogram. This is called EEG. In this electroencephalogram, we are seeing that our brain is generated the signals, and from electrodes we capture the signals and is recorded in electroencephalogram meter. The electrodes are placed in the skull of the brain. In this context, our today's topic is event-related potential, ERP. An event-related potential is the measured brain response that is the direct result of a specific sensory, cognitive or motor event. More formally, it is an stereotype electrophysiological response to the stimulus. The study of the brain in this way provides a non-massive means of evaluating brain functions. ERPs are measured by means of electroencephalography, EEG, the magnetoencephalography, MEG. Equivalency of ERP is a ERF, is the frequency related signals. With the discovery of electroencephalograms, which is covered in our previous lectures, in 1924, Hans Berger related that one could measure the electrical activity of human brain by placing electrodes on the skull, the amplifying the signals. These signals can be recorded through the electroencephalograms. Charge in voltage can be plotted over a period of time, and we can plot a graph of charge versus voltage. He observed that voltage could be influenced by external event that stimulated the sense. That means when the brain signal is generated, the signals can be influenced by outer signals, by outer event. Suppose we are sleeping, the signals may be different. Suppose we are jogging, the brain signal may be different. Suppose we are in this situations where some anger part is there, when some sad part is there. So different situations, brain signals are different. The EEG proves that it is useful source of recording brain activity over ensuing decades. However, it tends to be very difficult to access the highly specific neural process that are the focus of cognitive neuroscience, because using pure EEG data made it difficult to isolate individual neurocognitive process. Event related potential offer more sophisticated method of extracting more specific sensory, cognitive or motor event by using simple averaging techniques. Basically, we are segregating the signals with different event-related potentials so that our work is easy, and we are defining a specific techniques. In 1935 to 1936, the scientist Puglia and Davies recorded the first known ERP on awake human, and their finding were published in a few years later in 1939. Due to the World War II, not much research was conducted in 1940, but research focusing on sensory issued picked back again, and in the 1950 again the research started. In 1964, the colleagues began a modern era of ERP component discovery when they reported on the first cognitive ERP component called cognitive native variations. So ERP is a very useful mechanism to record the human brain signals in different situations with different potentials and different factors. The scientists and the researchers are very much aware about this particular topic, this particular point, and the research is going on, and it is helpful for the human being to record their various emotions, cognitive psychology, neurosensitiveness in different parameters. So today's topics we are covered. Is there any query? Please mention on the suggest box. Thank you.